it might. That's just preaching on me. That we might hear from you. And we give you thanks. In Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ashenego. You're worthy, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So I can fly above my situation, lest I move from this place. I'll be consumed by my temptations. Mount me so I can fly where I am. Mount me on the wings of an eagle. Above my circumstances, if I stay here too long, I'll be consumed by my own weakness. Mount me so I can fly. I can fly.
find your way. Now I'm going to a land where joy shall never end. Oh, fly away. Help me so I can fly from where I am.
Yeah.
sit down and let me preach now.
Let me preach.
I want y'all to get that one out.
It's about to explode, y'all. Let me get out.
Oh, God. Song of Solomon.
Better go right out of jail, brother.
Song of Solomon. All right, God. Chapter 1.
You need a fly, Reverend.
You need a fly, man. Oh, Jesus. Let me read this text. Y'all better stand. Come on. Oh, have mercy.
Jump off, Reverend. Y'all keep pushing me. Y'all better stop. Called Song of Solomon, whichever one you designate. This is an erotic and sensual book. It is a book of two lovers expressing their passion one for another. Love between two human beings. The book, Sister Humphrey of Solomon, or Book of Song of Songs, does not mention the name explicitly of God. However, when you talk about love at its purest, all love, when it's pure, Reba, has its source in God. Can I get a witness? For God is what? Love.
And love, when it's rightly expressed,
is beautiful. Can I get a witness in here? There is just something about being in love. Wish I had a witness in here. I said there is something about being in love. Something about that one person that just makes your heart skip a beat. I need a witness in here. I need to get a witness in here that can testify that there's just that one person in your life. For you married folk, I hope it's that spouse of yours. But it's that person in your life that makes your, that just causes you to smile every time you think about them. Can I get a witness in here? Some of y'all, yeah, amen. There is nothing more greater than the object of love. Because love is a creative force that makes people better. Can I get a witness? This book, the speakers are both a male and a female, and a chorus called the Daughters of Zion, or Daughters of Jerusalem. In this text, the woman is the speaker of the text. We don't know who this woman is. She might be a Shunammite woman. Somebody shout Shunammite woman. She's from a place called Shunammite. She begins this poetic expression, Tasha, by saying, I am black and beautiful. Now, some translations get that wrong. Because some of your versions might say, I'm black but comely. Or I'm black and beautiful. Now, believe it or not, Shannara, that there is a distinction between black and beautiful and black but beautiful. For when you say, I am black but beautiful, it seems to suggest that there's something wrong with being black. But when you say, I'm black and beautiful, it seems to suggest that who I am is a gift from God. Can I get a witness in here? Is there anybody that can testify that who I am is a gift from God? I am fearfully and wonderfully. I wish I had a witness in here. There is nothing ugly about me. There is nothing detestable about me. I know who I am. Can I get a witness in here? This woman. She says, I'm black but beautiful, like the tent of Kedar and the tent of the curtain of Solomon. That is to say, she has had some experiences. Yes, I'm dark, but there's something beautiful about my blackness. Now, some scholars have suggested that this blackness may not be her pigmentation, but it might have been her exposure to the constant sun. For if you read the next verse, she says, watch this, don't look at me because I have been dazed by the sun. She has had been constantly exposed to the sun, which caused her skin to become dark. All right. Now, why was she exposed to the sun? Well, because Lamar, she was exposed to the sun because her brothers had a hatred of her. We don't know why they hated her, but we know they had a sincere hatred of her, and for that reason, they forced her to work in the vineyard. Now, when you talk about working in the vineyard is a place where grapes are made, and you know when you make grapes, you know what else comes with grapes. That's got grape juice, and then there's another thing that you make. Can I get a witness in the church? Y'all know about apothic red wine. Y'all know about Concord red wine. Moscato. Let me move in my sermon here. She said, I was forced to work in and work the vineyard, literally, but I could not work my own vineyard. Now, when she talks about her own vineyard, she's not talking about a literal vineyard. She's talking about her beauty. She's saying, I'm taking care of somebody else, but I was unable to take care of my own beauty. But yet in verse 5, she says, I'm black and beautiful. I'm going to get back to that in a minute. Then verse 7, she says, she turns her attention to her lover. Now, as we approach this passage, as we think about the beauty of our blackness, the text invites us to reflect upon about our own beauty. And the question that is must be raised today, what makes our blackness beautiful?
What is it, Reverend?
What is it that makes blackness beautiful?
What is it, Reverend?
Is it our pigmentation?
Well,
is it the fact that we are good looking people? For I must say this today, that you and I must take pride in how we look.
Yeah.
I should have had a witness in here. I said, you and I ought to take pride in how we look, because we live in a society that disrespects, devalues the black body. But you and I must value and cherish ourselves. To affirm ourselves is to say, I am fully human. I am fearfully and wonderfully made.
Amen.
Now watch this.
Watch it, Reverend.
She didn't wait for somebody else to tell her she was beautiful.
Oh, I'm watching, Reverend.
She said, I'm black.
Yeah.
And I'm beautiful.
Yeah.
I need to tell somebody that's always looking for somebody to tell you pretty. Always somebody got to tell you you sexy.
Right.
I need some folks that can testify that when I woke up this morning, I woke up in the mirror and I said, mirror, mirror. I need a witness up in here. In fact, I looked at the mirror the first time and said, good, you look good waking up. And then when I got dressed, I said, good, you look sexy now. Can I get on? I need some room. See, the reality is, brothers and sisters, some of us are ashamed of the way we look. Don't you ever let anybody cause you to feel ashamed about who you are.
Amen.
Because at the end of the day, they missing out.
Yeah.
Come on. I love my black chocolate self. And they said the black of the belly, I'm juicy, y'all. This week, and on Friday, this funeral, lady got up to give remarks. The deceased was about, I believe, in her 70s, something around that age, around there. And the lady got up and said she was one of those sexy seniors. What I'm trying to get at is this: that who you are, you're good looking, you being who you are, has no age factor. Can I get a witness in here? If you're 70, you ought to look like a good, sexy senior.
Right.
Can I get a witness in here?
Right.
You ought to take pride. Can I get a church in here?
Yeah.
Can I get some folks that can testify? I know I look good. I can still strike my step.
Yeah.
Know how to cut a corner. I'm moving on. But Sister Rouse, Lord have mercy.
Yes,
people often tell these young people, talk about you look like a snack.
Yeah.
A snack? I'm a full course meal. Lift your hands and shout yeah! Busters are. But Shamelia, I can't stop at natural beauty. Because if you stop at natural beauty, you're being superficial and surface. Let me help those who are only in love because of what you see. If all you can see is what you see, you in trouble. Can I get away? Because of beauty, can I tell you, is skin deep. Can I get a witness in here? I forgot, music song John just came up in my head. Nakia, beauty is beyond external. So I gotta return back to my question, Brother Terrence. What makes black beautiful? What is it? If it isn't just my good looking, if it isn't my wavy hair, that's part of it. What is it if it's more than that? Sister Ruby McCaffrey, I will give the answer. Here's what makes our black beautiful. Watch this. Our black beauty evolves from our ugly experiences. Can I say it again? Our black beauty, Sister Vandella, has come from our ugly experiences. This woman was ill-treated by her brothers. This is a patriarchal society. Now, a patriarchal society is a society that benefits men and dominated by man. And so everything is done for the benefit of man. This woman was relegated to work in the vineyard. She had, because her own brothers didn't like her. And there is still, while there is still racism, there's also sexism even in the church. Where we mistreat and demean women. Can I get a witness in here? Men, women are sexually harassed, not only in church, but also in the workplace. Am I in the right church here? They're denied opportunities. But brothers and sisters, I believe the text is trying to unfold for us that if anything, we've got to start seeing women, first of all, as being created in the image of a loving and liberating God. That is to say, and can I be practical right here? That is this, brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, that if they get rid of the ladies in the church, we ain't gonna have no church. Deacon Ryan, Brother Deacons, if the women march out of this church, we going with them. And whatever church they go, that's where we going.
Amen. They go get rid of us. Amen.
I'm with you, Reverend.
That's right.
They made her 10, Lord have mercy, the vineyard, Archie. And watch the text. She could not tend to her own beauty. But watch this. It was her ugly experiences that beautified her. Do you believe, brothers and sisters, that God can bring beauty out of ugly situations? Listen to me. Listen. When we think about the black experience, we ought to realize that we've had some bad experiences in our own lives. Can I get a witness? My favorite preacher, the Reverend Dr.
Charles E. Booth said something very profound as I was listening to a sermon this past week. Listen to this. Reverend Dr. Booth said, any black person who does not believe in God after looking at all they've been through ought to go to hell on a Concorde jet. Absolutely no explanation, JoJo, for us being in America, been going through all that we've been through, and still being who we are. If it had not been for the Lord on our side, I want to have a witness in here. Where would we be? Stolen?
Yes.
Stolen against our will and brought here to these souls to build America and not reap it from our labor.
Amen.
Being denied opportunities and even around church folk being forced, even being segregated, even in church. Our women being raped and our men being lynched, our churches bombed, and our ghettos are proliferating drugs and violence. But if it had not been, police officers disrespecting the black body, but I need to get some witnesses in here that can testify, and only God can keep us through all of the harsh realities. Can I get a witness in here? Some of you have lost your children due to gun violence, and you're wondering how you make it. I tell you how you made it. Nothing but the grace. Can I get a witness in here? And some of y'all are wondering, some of y'all have dealt with some personal things on your job. I'm going to get some witnesses in here that dealt with some personal health struggles. People who dealt with personal issues. Ain't nobody but God. I said this a few Sundays ago, that the real test of a Christian, one who has gone through the fire, is one who can go through, watch this, and don't look like they're going through. My struggles have beautified me, because I'm a witness that if God brought me to it, then God can bring me through it. Am I the right church here? Is there anybody that can testify that if God brought me to it, he's more than capable of bringing me through it? If God be for me, who can be against? Tell me, who can stand before us when we call on that great name? You're looking at me. Some of you have endured some worse troubles. Some of you have endured issues in your relationships, issues on your job, issues in your health, issues just personally, but you still manage to have a smile on your face. Can I get a witness in here? I struggle, but guess what? I still look good in my struggle. Can I get a witness in here? It's a struggle sometimes, make me wonder how I keep from going under. But I'll tell you how I keep from going under. Nobody but God. Can I get a witness in here? Can somebody tell us about nobody?
Nobody but God.
I've been out there. I was strung out but God. I was a dope addict, but God. I was a crackhead, but God. Sex addict, but God. I was miserable, but God. But God.
You are preaching.
Let me tell you something. No matter how ugly your experience, what the devil means for evil,
God
has a way I'm working that thing out for your glory. My point in my sermon that I want to make today is this. That before you can love anybody else, yes, you gotta love yourself. Yes. And love, that means love all the experiences you've been through. Yes. Can I get a witness in here? Yes. Because if you can't love yourself, how in the world you gonna love somebody else? Can I get an amen? You can't love nobody until you love you. And loving you means sometimes you gotta wake up in the morning and talk to yourself. Can I get a witness in here? You need to tell yourself, I am somebody. I'm often imitated but can't be duplicated. I'm special, I'm anointed, I'm intelligent, I'm educated, I'm black, I'm proud. Can I get a witness in here? Let me call Mace, let me call Sean Puppy Cone. Can I get a witness in here? Can I call them for a witness? Can I call them for a witness? I said, can I call them for a witness? I had another cone in my head, but that's gonna be all right today. I'm black and I'm proud. There's nothing wrong with me. Can I get a witness in here? I am somebody. Whether you believe it or not, look at somebody and say, neighbor, I am somebody. I am who I am because of Jesus. I am special. I am who God says I am. I had a quote by Sean Puffy Cone, and I just couldn't remember it.
That's all right.
But it's gonna be all right. Remember what it was.
That's all right.
But it's,
you gave the word,
I
brother.
I gave you what you needed.
You gave the word of God.
I'm black, but I'm beautiful. And I'm beautiful. Not but I'm beautiful. I'm black and I'm beautiful.
We heard from the Lord. Amen.
Love yourself. Self-love is not racist. Don't you ever feel critical about representing who you are. Don't be afraid for talking about black power. Because if nobody, ain't nobody else gonna tell us. So we need to tell ourselves. You are a child of love yourself.
Yeah.
Young people, love yourself. Don't let nobody disrespect you. Don't let nobody tell you who. Don't let society define and limit you. Don't you limit yourself. There's so much that you can accomplish because you are great. And I believe, brothers and sisters, all of us in here need to be reminded of our greatness.
Can I get a witness in here?
All of us need to be reminded of our greatness. Look at somebody next and tell them you're great.
You're great.
You're great. Now get up. Get up and give somebody a hug. Come on, get up and give somebody, don't, and encourage somebody. Somebody.
Okay.
stand together. And hold it down, honey, hold it down. Lamar, I found out what that book was. It slipped my mind. I found out what it was. Can't nobody take my pride. And can't nobody hold me down. Oh no, I gotta keep on moving. I couldn't remember that. I was in my moment, even my element. But you are great. And your greatness is connected to a great God. How great! Yeah.